Good morning, and welcome to the 10th Annual Renewing Lives Breakfast for the Franciscan Renewal Center, also affectionately known as the CASA. My name is Father Page, and I'm one of the Franciscan friars assigned here to our Renewal Center. It's been my experience and my observation that on these sacred grounds, many people come here over these last 70 years to find strength for themselves, to be renewed, to be transformed, and then give their lives to others in great service. I want to thank the CASA Board for their dedicated and committed leadership, the Sustainability Committee for their overriding and their taking care and watching over all of our fundraising, and for the Renewing Lives Breakfast Team, which has made today's event very possible. We're also very grateful to the Messengers Mortuary for their support of our Renewing Lives Breakfast. And we owe a great deal of thanks to Bill Masikas from Mountain Shadows Resort for his donating the one-night stay with breakfast for two. And anyone who is registered to be with us this morning is eligible to be the winner of this very nice gift. For 70 years now, the CASA has been in existence, and we've been renewing lives here. We've been helping people grow in their spiritual growth. We've been helping people be transformed and healed, and once again, finding themselves back into service for others. Today, you'll hear some very powerful stories of people who have been transformed, whose lives have strengthened by the work that continues on these sacred grounds. There is no way to know how many people have come on these grounds over these 70 years. They have found strength inside themselves. They have found strength by being with others, and many, many have renewed their relationship with their Lord. We are very grateful to you for joining us on this 10th Annual Renewing Lives Breakfast event.
Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain, we all have sorrow. But if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. If there is a load you have to bear that you can't carry, right up the road, I'll share your load if you just call me. You just call on me, brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem.
Good morning. Thank you for attending this year's Renewing Lives Breakfast. My name is Father Daniel Barica. I'm very blessed to be rector here at Our Lady of the Angels Church here at the Franciscan Renewal Center.
Good morning. I'm Charles Brown, the Executive Director.
And we're hoping that you're going to hear something that will change your life this morning. That's how it happened with St. Francis of Assisi. He heard Christ speak the words about rebuilding his church. He felt those words grab him by his heart, and it so changed him that he was able to reposition his life and point it right towards the gospel. Here at the CASA, we carry on his legacy, the Franciscan mission of renewing lives through healing and transformation, spiritual growth, and service to others. You know, it's one thing to hear the words of Jesus, But when we let them penetrate our hearts, like St. Francis, we become renewed and restored. That's how it happened to me. Years ago, I heard the words of the gospel, and this is the gospel that was a few Sundays ago. These are the words: put out into deep water and get ready for a catch. I fell in love with that invitation, and I chose that gospel for my priestly ordination because those were the words that grabbed my heart, and they have not let go. The reason I turned my life around to become a Franciscan and a Catholic priest is because I experienced Jesus wanting to go deeper. You know, we're all looking for that something that will transform our lives. What is that for you? We want to help you find it, and if you've already found it, then we invite you to support us in helping others find it. You'll hear in the stories today that people are finding something deeper here at the Casa that feeds them and has transformed them. This is the power of allowing Jesus to take us deeper. This is the joy in throwing out the nets and getting ready for the catch. Whether it's through our vibrant liturgies, our Faith in Action ministries, or our joyful welcome to those who come here for our programs. Past support has helped us to take our mission to so many beyond the Casa and throughout the world through our live streaming. We're also hoping that support today will help us to rebuild the church, rebuild community that has been so wounded through this pandemic. So many have been wounded and are in need of renewal and transformation. And this is what we do best here at the Casa, and we do it through donor support. There's an important reason why you're joining us this morning. Let Christ speak to your heart through the stories that you will hear today. Go deeper by supporting our good work at the Casa. Join us in our efforts to renew and transform the world.
Thank you, Father Daniel. I recently shared with a newer community member the impact of the Tao Society. Tao Society pledges provide needed funds to help ensure our annual expenses are met. With this financial base, we continue our forward-thinking approach and build budgets centered on our strategic plan and our mission, as we have for the past 70 years. Ministries and programs are developed to support the CASA community, as well as the community at large, which is international. What we hear over and over is the CASA's vibrant masses, coupled with quality programs and retreats, continue to change lives for the better. We estimate at least 1 million people's lives have been renewed since our founding 70 years ago. Despite the uncertainty and reduced staff in 2021, we remain dedicated to continuing our mission. And I'm happy to share that our inspiring masses and music expanded our worshiping community around the country. Attendance for in-person and online Sunday masses was well over 154,000, matching our pre-pandemic attendance. Over 800 professional behavioral health counseling and therapy sessions were provided to anyone in need on a donation basis, where no one was ever turned away for lack of funds. And another 250 supervision sessions, where Franciscan values are taught to future therapists in training. And we provided full scholarships for our veterans retreats, where nearly 500 veterans attended at no cost to them. We continue to keep our prices of our adult education classes and retreats affordable, so all can attend, even though costs have risen. Fee of a retreat today is nearly at the price 10 years ago. We must maintain and repair our 86 lodging rooms, our 24 conference rooms, our offices, and our beautiful church. However, costs continue to increase, as you know, 15 to 20% every single year. Medical benefits and fair compensation must be provided for our professional staff of employees who work tirelessly to support the day-to-day needs of our ministries and this community. The CASA is a busy yet serene place where a variety of people and groups enjoy our campus, creating quite an eclectic atmosphere. On any given day, the place comes alive with happenings all over our 25 acres. And during the past 10 years, The Tao Society has created the foundation for spiritual and transformational possibilities to occur at the Casa. I could go on for hours sharing the miracle stories that happen through the Casa by the grace of the Holy Spirit. So it is indeed with tremendous gratitude for our Tao Society that I say thank you so very much. May we continue building the Tao Society as the bedrock of our long-term sustainable funding. It's important for me that you know, whenever you see someone here on retreat, taking a class, volunteering, or doing an outreach ministry, or maybe benefiting from the many other opportunities that we provide, that you and your support are what making a difference in these people's lives. Don't just take my word for it. Hear the Casa story through the words of the people that we serve. Thank you.
So with my retirement, I really wanted to be able to serve. And so the Casa has been extremely important in the sense of offering, I don't know, 11 or 12 different ministries through Faith in Action that gave me a chance to not only explore, but dive much more deeply into my own spiritual development while I helped others. My name's Michael Powell, I'm retired. I first became more involved in the CASA when I signed up for the Nonviolence Leadership Certificate Program. Act Love Walk became available, and I guess formerly it was known as Faith Formation Program. And I felt that was really important. It's a 7-month process of meeting every week and really learning about social justice issues, economic and environmental inequality, and how we can better get to know one another as people, and rather than objectifying one another. The thing that the Franciscan Renewal Center offers is an opportunity to learn things fresh. And so I made a real point to come with an open mind to all my classes, okay, and go, you know, this is all new for me. And even though I might have had a lot of knowledge and information and facts as it related to the variety of situations that we would talk about, I had a beginner's mind, which is a Buddhist term, basically, you know, in understanding and approaching that. And that was really important to me. It was a verification that the changes that I felt the CASA may be able to provide me through not only the teachings that are offered and the ministries that we can become involved in, but also the environment and the ability to do ministry amongst a community of people, but also have the place to have the time for reflection and contemplation. The CASA has been the vehicle from which God has given me grace. So within that grace, I'm able to be part of, I think, a life's work of soul development and learning. I'm very grateful to the CASA, and I thank you know, the friars and the staff and the community members and all of those that I've had an opportunity to interact with during this last 4 or 5 years, because I feel I've been welcomed and accepted. All right, and it's really important to me that that I do the same for others.
Good morning. My name is Erica Tatum Shade.
And I'm Matthew Shade.
We are often asked, why the CASA? We were an interfaith family, and it was important to us to find a place that not only matched our values, but a place where we felt we belonged. We wanted our children to be in a faith community that not only embraced them, but gave them the tools they needed to grow. We attended many churches around the valley, and each time walked away feeling like something was missing. We were familiar with the CASA, as my husband had attended on and off growing up, and he was part of the counseling ministry. The first time we visited the CASA as a family, we felt instantly embraced, and we knew that this would be our faith home. We joined the faith formation classes as a family and participated in the RCIA classes. The CASA provided that sense of community that we were looking for. and kept us rooted in our faith. It also helped our children develop their sense of faith.
Growing up, it was hard to understand my faith while moving from church to church, trying to find something that lined up with our morals. I was a very curious child, and I still am, and I wanted a lot of answers about who I am, my relationship with God, and what's kind of the point of it all. The first time we went to the CASA, I knew that I had found a place that not only taught the morals that I was taught by my parents, but what I believed in my heart. The CASA talked of a loving, kind, and caring God, and about how we were all created equal in the eyes of God. The CASA allowed me and pushed me to explore my faith for answers, especially in the faith formation classes and as I continue with Life Teen now. I've never felt closer to my faith than right now, and it's all thanks to the CASA.
The CASA has provided the foundation we were looking for and the community where we feel we belong.
Good morning. I'm Karen Moscato from Bullhead City, Arizona, and I'm happy to be with you this morning to share my story. Close to 5 years ago, I was retiring and moving from South Bend, Indiana, to rural Arizona to be close to my two sisters. I had concluded a 30-year career in human resources, leaving behind my executive position and the life I built in Indiana. At first, I was really excited about life's next chapter. I was envisioning all kinds of possibilities. But as the days wore on in my new surroundings, the barrenness of the landscape, the loneliness of leaving all I left behind, cast me in a deep darkness. As I continued to feel lost and could no longer hear the voice of God, I knew I needed to find something that was recognizable to me. And that took the shape of a retreat center. You see, earlier in life, I made many retreats as a Franciscan Sister of the Sacred Heart outside Joliet, Illinois. They grounded me in my Franciscan spirituality. 12 years later, I transferred to the Sisters of the Holy Cross at Notre Dame, Indiana, where I was immersed in Catholic social justice teaching, and I was able to minister to the marginalized. And yet something was still missing. So I left religious life and began my corporate career while continuing in spiritual direction to see, hear, and build the kingdom of God. Back in Arizona, I was Googling retreat centers and I was elated. Not only did I find a retreat center, but it was a Franciscan retreat center. And that's how I found the CASA. During my 5-day private retreat, my spiritual director guided me to recognize my life in Indiana as a blessing. I was able to grieve, let it go, and reframe my sorrow without judgment to the joy of being called to the desert. I was beginning to hear God's voice again. This was the start of my transformation, my finding my way back to me. And it was also preparation for what was to come. A month later, my sister was diagnosed with a rare form of cancer. So we rented a home in Gilbert, Arizona, to be close to the hospital where she would receive treatment to save her life. Again, the CASA was there for me, to be my rock through my sister's radiation, chemo, and eventual surgery. I was able to worship every Sunday with the faith community, giving me the strength and support to care for my sister. I'm happy to share that she has been in remission since 2019. The CASA has loved me enough to be desirous of change, to see the beauty in my new surroundings here in Arizona. The CASA continues to love me through each workshop and retreat I attend, through the liturgy and Taze of the Cross that I stream, through the monthly spiritual direction I engage in, and through my volunteer work with the faith in ministry. All are integrated with my call to discipleship. Now, I can use my foundation in creation spirituality and Catholic social justice teaching in new ways. Through this continuing guidance from the CASA, I am constantly asking myself, what does my community need and how can I serve? Even though I am connected to the faith community through technology, I am joined to you in spirit to bring about the kingdom of God. Thank you for being my Franciscan community. I am grateful to be walking this path in solidarity with all of you. Thank you.
Thank you for those truly inspirational stories. I too have received several of the many transformational and healing gifts of our ministries, and I can share personally that my life has been enriched in tremendous ways. For not only myself, but my lovely daughters Amber and Bridget, and my mother Eileen, who also is a TAO member. We continue to be inspired by the work done here in over 70 years of existence. We stand on the shoulders of thousands of benefactors who have kept the CASA flourishing. So I'm here to ask for your help. This morning you heard powerful stories of the CASA's impact on the lives of people who come here. And there are many, many CASA miracles. People believe that the Sunday offerings pay for all this work. It's actually not even nearly enough to fund all the ministries that happen here every single day. We need your additional support to continue our outreach. This is who we are as a community. This is how we put our faith into action. And first, I want to say that we will be very grateful for any help that you can help us with. I am proud that I am a 10-year member of the TAO Society, one of the 380 families in our community who have made this choice. It is a 5-year pledge of at least $1,000 per year. These unrestricted funds support the people and the good work you heard about today. How? How is it done? Well, it's really easy. You will see the pledge button on your screen that offers a variety of giving options. They are $5,000, $10,000, and $25,000. And of course, you can choose any other amount as well. If you have other ideas of how you would like to contribute, please check the box and be assured that we will give you a call. So a gift of $5,000 per year will help us continue supporting our retreat costs, keeping those prices affordable. A gift of $10,000 per year helps support our 2 full-time staff in the Faith in Action Outreach Ministries, who have nearly 400 volunteers. A gift of $25,000 a year supports our budget of nearly $300,000 a year to keep our grounds beautiful and safe. These are just a few examples of how your dollars may be spent. For those of you who already are TAO members, like me, thank you. And I ask that you please consider increasing or extending your pledge right now. I plan to do so today. Thank you, everyone. Please know that the friars and all who have been and will be renewed at the CASA greatly appreciate your generosity. Now, Father Vincent will conclude us with prayer. Thank you.
Dear holy people of God, thank you very much for joining our Renewing Lives breakfast today. We truly appreciate your time to be with us and your goodwill to support us. Each of you has played a very important role in our mission here at the CASA, and we would not be who we are today without you. As you have helped us to help others, we ask our loving God to shed His grace and love upon you always. May the Lord give you peace and all good.